right now you're all muted, but I'll allow you guys to talk if you ever want to talk. Like, I wanted to make it, we wanted to make it so that it's more of a, you know, a personal interaction with each other. Like, we may be in different places, you know, in the States, or maybe there might be people, you know, who are not in the States who are actually with us today, but we want to be able to see your faces and you see us. And, you know, there's a face to the organization. There's a face to all of us. And, you know, like I said, the past two and a half years of COVID, where we had to be away from each other, was pretty tough. And I always, you know, we always think back to the times when we used to do these, you know, these symposiums where we had, like, you know, about hundreds of people together, where we could share information, we could talk to each other and just, you know, interact. So,
well, I just, I can't tell you how much I appreciate, Justin, your willingness to jump from the webinar kind of program that you've normally done into this opportunity where we can actually see each other. Some of these folks I know, and some I work with, and some I don't know. And yet what I do know is that the thing we have in common is that we are all living in a body. Mm-hmm. We're all living in a body. And we have some level of five senses. I'm just going to begin it there so we can actually exhale a little bit. Exhale a little bit. So for just a second, close your eyes. You don't need to see me or anyone else. And I want you to use your imagination as your eyes are closed. In the space where you sit, I want you to imagine something that you've seen in that space before. Don't cheat. Just imagine something that you've seen in that space before. It might be a person, it might be a painting, might be your favorite artwork. Just let it float into your mind. And then I want you to shift to your hearing. Eyes closed. Imagine something that you have heard in that space before. Probably not my voice. It's something else you've heard. And let that float into your mind. And then I want you to take just a second, and I want you to think about something that you tasted in that room before. Don't open your eyes. I'm not cheating. Something you've tasted in the room where you are. And then we're going to move to the sense of smell. Take a deep breath, eyes closed. Let it out. And let your mind remember something that you've smelled in that place where you are sitting before. Then one more remaining sense, the sensation of touch. So keep your eyes closed, take your palms, and let them touch each other. Oh yeah. And allow that touch to connect you with your now body. Your now body. The physical sensations. Do you have pain somewhere? Tightness? Fatigue in your body? And then I want you to connect with your mind, which is part of your body, the mental and the physical. Operate together, not separately. Eyes still closed. Is your mind a little bit more relaxed than it was 5 minutes ago? More curious, less anxious. Then if it feels right, take those palms that are touching each other and let them touch your chest, your heart, your lungs. Take a breath. And sense your emotions right now. Your emotions right now. No need to fake it. No need to polish it over. No pretending. True emotions. And the eyes still closed. Those palms touching your chest. I would invite you to take three nice, long, deep breaths. And you're all muted, so don't worry. You can make a sound with that exhale. When you're ready, I invite you to let your eyelashes flutter just a little bit and open and allow yourself to see that screen again. And notice what you see. You see some smiles? You see some smiles? I bet you do. So that thing that we feel when we're like doing a new thing on the internet with a new program called Zoom, which we all have become quite intimate with in the last couple of years, and there are like screeching sounds in the background. All we really need to do is to pause and come back into our bodies using the senses that we use every day. Every day. All right, so speed date here on what is Nia. I myself consider myself to be a sensation scientist. And why is that? Because Nia is based on sensation. And what is sensation? It's what you feel. So if you tickle your arm, there is something that you feel. And it might be a positive or a negative kind of sensation. And so we learn to track sensation, to know what feels good and what doesn't, and to always choose in our everyday life what feels better. It's kind of like, and when I'm tired, it must mean I need to rest. And then choosing rest as best you can, based on how your life supports you in that way. So what we're working with is helping people find sustainable health and well-being in the physical body, the mental, the emotional body, which gets fired in a zillion different ways, and the spirit body, which is the truest part of you. It's the thing that makes you smile. And the thing that you do, maybe, that makes other people smile, that generates joy in other people. My specialty is helping people feel better. Who wants to feel better? Anybody? I know, it's like, raise your hand. Raise your hand if you want to feel better. We use some things. We have some tools that we use in Nia. And actually, before I get to the tools, I'll answer the question that was asked last week. What does NIA stand for? What does Nia mean? It began many years ago, about 40 years ago, meaning neuromuscular integrative action. That's a lot. So, yeah, Jeff, I see you going, yeah, that's a lot. Neuromuscular integrative action. Now I am here in my now body, bringing what my body brought to this screen this morning, sensing my body and moving in ways that help me feel better. I'll say that one more time. I'm here now in my now body, the body that sat down in the chair for this little gathering, sensing my body, what feels good and what doesn't, in order that I might move in ways that help me feel better, which means if you're not comfortable in your chair, please wiggle until you are. So wiggling is encouraged, right? Changing, rearranging is encouraged. Sitting in one position doesn't help us so much in the long term. So the tools, back to Nia and moving to heal. The moving to heal is the therapeutic arm of the Nia practice. Therapeutic arm. It's usually done barefoot. Why? You've got 7,000 nerve endings in each foot. And when that barefoot touches the ground, the sensation from underneath and behind your body changes through your whole body, right? We use awareness, paying attention. We use what we call sensory IQ through your awareness and through observing the way you move. You create a sensory IQ for yourself. And as that IQ gets higher, then you're able to manage your movement in ways that are more automatic rather than, I'm going to choose this. It will just happen. It will just be a part of your system and it'll just happen. We get great feedback from this class, and people appreciate the fact that we're living a little bit outside the medical box. We're a holistic practice, and so we do step outside of the medical box, and we don't say we're going to cure anything, but we do say that we can help you feel better. And again, thumbs up on feeling better. I don't know anybody that doesn't want to. We know that your body is designed for balance, and we also know that it can find its way out of balance at times. And so how do we use movement to bring all of the body, mind, spirit, emotions back into balance so that we walk out of the room after a class or after a short meditation. I don't know about you, the very beginning of a class helped me really settle in my body and in my mind. And that's what we experience. One of your tools, probably your number one tool, is curiosity. I don't know why we're doing this, right? And I don't know why it makes me feel better, but for some crazy reason it does. And then just be with it. That's cool. And we bring along some other tools, like the chair you might be sitting in, and you might be standing behind it later or beside it should you decide to move standing. It's meant to be your tool, not a crutch, but a tool. We're going to use movement as medicine. That's a tool. That's a tool. When you think of movement as medicine, different than just popping a pill, something that you are in charge of, that you are at choice with, in relationship with your body. A few other tools, we call them the sensations. So you can come with me if you like. We'll go through them. Big, long, wide fingers. This is the sensation of energy moving out along your bones. It's called flexibility. It's part of yoga. Then we have the sensation of agility. Every time you take a step, there's a stop and a start. And one step flows into the other. Sha, sha. Mobility. This is one of my favorites. Marilyn, she's totally got it going. My friend Marilyn Kahn down there, she's got the mobility going. Oh, this is one of my favorites. It's tickling anything and everything and everybody without offending anybody, right? It's just tickling. So we got flexibility, we got agility, we got mobility. Now, are you ready for some strength? Give it a little growl, right? And I want you to feel that energy that was moving out along the bones in flexibility. When we go to strength, it moves in along the bones towards the center of the body. I got it, right? Strong. And then out of that comes stability. So just go ahead and like put your arms out to the side and imagine yourself walking on a tight rope. Just imagine it. You can even put one foot in front of the other. You're all in a stable position. And just imagine that middle finger like a balance pole, a walking pole. Can you sense it? And can you shift your weight? And so our ultimate is to reach that place of stability that allows us to move safely through the world. Now, is anybody saying, wow, that kind of hurts my shoulders? Watch this. Bring them down. If it hurts, don't do it. Do less. Make good choices for your body. So we got the senses, which we played with in the beginning. We got the sensations. We've got 9 movement forms from the martial arts, the dance arts, and the healing arts. We play with Tai Chi, slow movement of energy. We play with Taekwondo, cha-cha, the agility of power and strength. We play with Aikido, movement from the belly, from the center of the body. So if you just create a little wave for yourself as you're sitting in your chair now, you'll have that sense of moving from the center of your body. We call it the hara, the one point. And then we come into the dance arts. Duncan dance is the playful you. And we're going to play a little bit today. The playful you, the childlike you. We have jazz, which is about expression. And it comes, again, out of these hands, wrists, elbows, and arms. All that jazz. Try that word. I can't hear any of you, so just let's say it together. 1, 2, 3. All that jazz. Can you feel it in your mouth? Do it one more time. All that jazz. That's what it's about. Expression. Expression. Modern dance, shapes and space, sculpture. Your body can become a sculpture. A sculpture, a moving sculpture. And then we go into the healing arts. And the healing arts, of course, include your favorite yoga, which many of you, how many of you have practiced yoga over the years of your life? Yeah, some of you have. Some of you have. And then the work of Moshe Feldenkrais, who said, for goodness sakes, he didn't say that. He didn't say it quite like that. But he said, for goodness sakes, slow it down. Slow it down and truly notice. Particularly, I'm going to speak specifically to people with cervical dystonia. Notice tiny, minuscule movements in one direction or another, even changing the direction of your eyes, looking up or down or slightly to the left, and slow it down so that you truly have a sense of what works and what doesn't. What puts you past positive tension and into a place of pain. We want you to be in a place of pleasure. And then we have one more healing art. And this is kind of funny. I keep forgetting these. We got Feldenkrais. Who am I missing? KK, help me one more time. Yoga, Feldenkrais.
Start with an A.
Alexander Technique.
Yeah!
I love it. So Alexander Technique is about moving from the top rather than from the bottom. We kind of get used to trudging through life. One heavy step at a time. And yet when we bring our posture up and tall and we imagine this great big feather on the crown of your head and you begin to move from the lightness of a feather in the crown of the head. Then everything lightens up, even your memory, even my memory lightens up. Yeah. Yeah. All right. So why do Nia? If you want to increase your energy, your cardiovascular fitness, which we can do no matter what our condition is, there is always a way. You want to improve your coordination, your mobility, your ability to stop and start. People with movement disorders often have issues with that. You want improved balance. You want to feel more stable as you just walk around your house. Yeah, we can begin there, even before we get out the door. You want to be stronger. You want mental clarity. You want to be able to express yourself. Yeah. You want more confidence. You want to connect. And so connection looks like what you see here on the screen. It looks like that. It looks like that. Neuroplasticity is a big part of what we do in the Nia Technique, and we'll play with some of that today by using different patterns to movement. And I would invite you to remain in curiosity. So I'm going to start some music. I'll have a few words to say, and I want you to do your wiggling so that we're sure that you are completely comfortable in your space. This can be done seated or standing. I'll do part of the class seated. I'll do part of the class standing. You will always have a choice. And your choice can also be to simply take it in with your eyes, to take it in with your ears, to breathe in the sound of the music. It might even give you a taste. And hopefully you will experience the sensation of I feel better. So we're going to begin. I will take my place in my chair and walking my hip joints towards the front of my chair. Let's see, Justin, you do have me pinned for everybody so they can see me big. Yes. Yes. Comfort is so important. Stability. Bring your toes together, your heels slightly apart. And I want you to give yourself permission to simply sway in some way. And using touch, any direction, soften your eyes. Always need to watch me. It's your choice. Step our feet into something that we call open stance. Feet stacked underneath the hip joints, parallel to each other. We're going to use the palms. Palms up. And then draw those elbows in close to the sides of your body. And make a small circle. A yawn, if you will. There's your flexibility. We're going to begin a new movement. Forward and back. There's the agility, the beginning and the end. And the yawning. Long bones. We'll do it again. Here's the biggest yawn yet. Smile through that yawn. Now we're going to catch a yes. It looks like this. Yes, there's the string. Let it go. Catch another one. Yes. Let that one go. Now a soft yes. Yes. And rest your palms. Are you ready for some fun? So, heel, 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 heel. So if it's too fast, you can slow it down. You can use your palm, the heel of your hand. Let the words speak to you. What's in front of you? Now, if it fits, you can use both heel of the hand. Yep. One foot, two heels. It's a little like crawling.
So why is it so hard to stay?
We pull it back every time we return. Now, quiet the feet and just use your arms side to side and around. Side to side and around. How much for you?
I want you to breathe, breathe slow.
Now this time our feet are going to come to the side. Watch it slow. It just steps out to the side.
Try to go inside and find what you're all about.
You can let your eyes roll towards it. Arm reach across.
Sometimes
a tiny twist in the spine, a little spiral.
Sometimes
it's made for it. That's it. Sometimes
so
you take it slow. We're gonna use the heel to the front. Let's speed it up. Here we go.
So
four,
breathe,
three,
breathe,
reach across.
Slow.
Low. There's one and one more. To the front four times. Four, three, and reach across slow. Now let your arm bone float. And the other arm bone floats. And touch your heart. And remember that reach forward. And
you can
pull
lay
it back
your
and
down.
Let the other arm float.
It's in this place you feel comfortable.
Back to the heart.
From all the pressures.
Reach
the
in.
Pressures of this
now remember
society.
That fist. I want you to feel a little of the pressure. Yes. Pressure sometimes motivates us. Got it. Are you ready? We're going back to the heel to the front.
So just breathe, breathe.
Give me four more. There's four and three and two. We're going
to
reach across slow. Slow. Back to the front. Heel. Four more. Reach across slow. There's slow. And slow. And slow. Are you ready to float? One arm, any arm, and then the other as best you can. Hard touch. Reach in and return and let the other float. Eyes and hands playing with each other in space. Let's do the scoop again. Only if you like. Only if you like.
Down to the river.
We pause here
and
get a little wider. A little wider with your feet. Yes, I could be standing.
I feel the cold.
Feel your balance.
Of the fire.
And feel the down.
'Cause it's my time.
Of your whole foot. We're simply gonna walk. Walk. And if you like, you can pat.
You gotta move.
You gotta move.
When your soul says
move. Yeah.
You gotta move. When your soul says move.
Can we double it? Let's try.
You gotta
two,
fly.
Two, two, two.
When your arms two. Fly.
Now let's stop and let your arms fly.
You gotta fly. Fly. When your arms fly.
We're gonna reach high with the tips of your fingers. We go wide. We bring it in. Right there. We come out. Now don't fall down, but look over your toes and sweep. Your eyes back into the high point. You ready? Here we go.
You gotta walk.
We're gonna cross the body with the palms.
When your feet say,
only if it feels good to you. Now, what if you can't
you gotta
move
walk.
Your head so easily? Just let your eyes
when
roll.
Your feet say,
just let walk. Your eyes roll. Let's double it.
You gotta
two.
Dance.
You gotta dance. When your hips say dance, you gotta dance.
You gotta dance.
Don't think. Let yourself have fun.
When your hips say dance.
Are you ready for the spirit? We're going up.
When a spirit
right there. You. Bring it in.
When a
right there. Bring it out.
You.
Don't fall down. Just look down. Fold we call it a spinal down. Roll. If you can touch the earth, let
you
your palms touch
down.
The earth. And then let those creepy crawler tickle fingers walk back up your legs and back to your thighs. Let's go again.
Whoa.
Now let your legs rest. We're gonna clap.
You gotta clap.
Any rhythm you like.
When your hands say clap.
Yeah, Jeff. Go, Jeff. Go, Jeff. I see
clap.
You, buddy. Go, Jeff. Yeah.
When your hands say clap.
Now, how fast can you clap? Find out.
You gotta go.
Kind of like applause,
when
right?
Your heart say go.
How slow can you clap?
You gotta go. When your heart say go.
We're going out.
And when a spirit get to you.
Bring it in. We're going out. Now don't fall down. Just look over your toes and touch down if you can. So take your time. We get to do this two or three times. Let your body sense it. That feather of Alexander technique. Allowing your skull to float with ease. And float back up with ease. Play with it. It's your toy. It might be tiny, tiny movements of your eyes. I love it. I love it. I love it.
'Cause it's my time.
It's your time.
My time.
To be born. Ready? Can we walk and clap? It's your time. stop right here. Now you can do this sitting or standing. Imagine you're at the piano. At the piano, we're talking about creepy crawlers. The song Chopsticks, if you like, one finger. Then all fingers, let them play. Now big chords. This is the strength part. Are you ready to run up and down the keyboard? Oh yeah. Is it too fast? Slow it down. Can you slow it even more? Would you like to become the conductor now? Here we go. Palms down and then palms up. A little faster, but smaller. You got it. Now look surprised. Here we go. You're awake. I don't know, how many pianists in the room? Here we go, now play anywhere. Are you ready to bang a little? Let's bang. There's your strength, we call it claw hands. This was little me that didn't want to practice. Here we go. One finger feels better than the other. Use that one. Use that one. And I'll teach you sign language for enough. It looks like this. That's how you find your way to rest. That's how you find your way to rest. But we've got more for you. Are you ready? This can be done from the chair or not. I'm going to adjust my camera a little bit. I'm going to do this standing. You can move your feet if you're seated. I'm just going to step together. See that move? We're gonna go this way. Add a little shine and let the other hand hold the space. Toes out and in. It looks like the twist. Take it easy. We're gonna walk that way. This hand holds the space. Waves of vibrations over relics. You got it. Wellness, precious moments. These toes, the twist. Angelic talent, like a picture spoken in scripture. Listen to the morning born from hope in the midst of enigmas. Ocean of rhythm, sweet and brutal. We're going to go just a little bit faster. Here we go. Four, three, two, toes out. A little chubby chicken. Four, three, two, toes out. Now one big step, here we go, one, and the other side, one. Arms can be low, you got it, anything that works for you. Are you ready to travel again? This way, here we go, four, three, two, remember the twist, you got it. We're going that way. Four, three, push away with your feet. We're going to do it again. Have 1% more fun. 1% more fun, yeah. That way. Go down. Remember the one big step? Here it comes. One. 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 Stay with it. One. When you use that word, your brain understands one step, one step, one step, one step. Now, more about you than me, make it yours. How do you move it side to side? Stability. One leg stepping, the other letting go. Now four steps. Here we go. There's four, three, two, toes out. Here we go. Yeah. Let's do it again. Four. Are you shining inside? Are you shining inside? Are you doing what you can do? If you are, you're shining. One big step this way. One, wait, settle. One, wait, settle. All right, we're gonna use that strength. So we call this a fist pump. It's a little like a starburst, right? There's an in, out. So I'm using my left hand right now. You're seeing it as my right. Try the other one. How does it work compared to the other? You might feel a difference. Now let's try them both together. Add a sound with your tongue. Kind of like the sound of a T, right? Let's come back to that little wiggle. And as you're doing this, if you're standing, just shift in your weight in ways that feel good to you. Let your body shift. It's the music of your bones. Now we're going to go to the fist. Knock on the door. Travel if it feels right, and then knock, knock anywhere. And other way. Knock and knock and knock and knock anywhere. And switch. Knock anywhere. Looking good. I got you, Wes. Let's travel. Yeah. And knock. Back to the starburst. Close, open. Ha. Ha. What if you add the sound of ha? Ha. How about an O with creepy crawlers? Oh, ooh, ah, oh, so melodic. Yes, you hear it. Are you ready for the knock on the door? We're going this way. Knock, knock, knock. Now I want you to rattle it, rattle it. This way, knock, knock, knock. Now rattle it. Now just the other hand, rattle it. And punch, punch. Rattle, punch, anywhere, anyway, rattle. Yeah, yeah. You got it. Let's travel. There's 4, 3, 2, and let it rattle. This way. Punch, punch, punch. Let it rattle. Creepy crawlers, bring them in and out. Massage with your elbows. Alright, are you ready for a little sing-along? Now we're gonna keep you muted. All you need is a web space. There's one.
Reach out and touch somebody's hand.
Your hands.
Make this world a better place.
If you can. Here's the palm.
Reach out and touch somebody's hand. Make this world a better place. If you can.
Now I just want you to romance your body and let your body shift its way. You can have your partner with you, you know. If you got one in the room, bring them along. Might be a cat or a dog. You might know the words to the song. Change sides from time to time. And be sure you're ready. Are you ready?
Why don't you reach out and touch somebody's hand? Make this world a better place.
Let's touch again.
Reach out and touch somebody's hand. Make this world a better place. If you can.
I think you can. Dance with it.
If you see an old.
You can imagine an old friend, a loved one that you've seen in your space before, in your life. Yeah. Oh, beautiful. Give it a little more of your heart. Oh, you know it's coming. Here it comes. Are you ready? If I had you all here in the room, I'd be holding your hands. It'd look a little something like this. We'd let go of a foot. We'd strengthen each other. Oh, here it comes.
Reach out and touch. Reach out. Somebody.
Make this world a better place. Start with the other hand. Touch somebody's hand. Are you smiling? Touch somebody's hand. One more. You got it. Oh. Justin, do we have time for one more song or not? Thumbs up, he says. Here it is, seated or standing, you choose. It's about gratitude. Now I am here in my now body, grateful for my life.
Yeah, my
open
life,
the door to gratitude.
You're guest, you're the earth, you're the sun, you're the grass.
Bring your eyes
love,
up a little.
Hand, you're a bug, you're my eyes, you're a hug, you're the light in the dark.
Touch
you're
the your
spark,
heart.
You're my mom, you are water, you're the
oh,
stars,
there's a little hug right there,
friend,
and here's the
you're
on.
My dreams, you're my father, you're the ants on the ground, the miracles that surround.
We're gonna do it again.
Around, the hemisphere in the clouds. You're my friend, you're
like
my
you
soul,
really
you're
mean
my
it,
hope
yeah.
For tomorrow, you're the strength, you're
all
the
you've seen.
Exists,
heart open.
That are bliss, the gift to realize
the heart.
All that I am,
let's sway. How about a step touch if you got
all
it?
That I've been,
doesn't have to be big.
Be. It's a blessing
It's so amazing. And I'm grateful for it. Let's bring back that clap. Na 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 na. Na 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 na. Na 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 na. Stabilize.
You're the blessings every time I try to count. You're the lessons that I learn every time.
The heart.
You're the water when I'm burned every time.
The other.
Everything I'm looking for is
send out some love. Can add a little heal. You got it. You got it. Right there. Right there. Right here. Oh, you feel it. Give it away. It's a blessing. Amazing. Grateful. Let's do it again.
Day I sit and pray, cause what I have is more than I deserve or could ever imagine. How do I give back to all of this magic and
one
spread the love
through,
so everybody can have it? Doesn't matter if I'm rich or poor, if I got a family or if I'm all alone. Bad things happen, I can just complain and moan. But
I don't know, Justin, I think we gotta blow some kisses. Yeah? Lift up those fingers to your lips. Totally COVID safe here. Yeah. Blow those kisses. Oh, yeah. Are you ready? Stabilize. All that I am. All that I've seen. All that I've been. All I'll ever be. A blessing. So amazing. I'm grateful. Let's do it again. All that I am. All that I've seen. All that I've been. All that I'll ever be. It's a blessing. One more to the sky. Around to the heart. That hug. This one's for you, Justin. Yeah. You gotta remember to give yourself a hug every day. Pat yourself. Scent your body. Love your life.
Exist, the small things that are bliss, the gift to realize that everything is a gift.
Let it settle. Let's go to the shoulders. Let one roll, smoothing off any edges. I want you to notice while you roll that shoulder, are your toes relaxed? Are your knees soft? And then let's play with the other one. Notice the difference. Body left and right. And then let's come back to this open palm, as soft and gentle as if you were holding someone you love very much. And I'm going to invite you to let it be you. Bring your elbows close. Loved one, be you. One palm to the heart, the other palm to the heart. Safely soften your eyes. What do you see now? Just let those palms drop. If you're standing, find your way back to your chair. I will always recommend to you that if the music speaks to you, if music is something that you love, then you turn on the music that moves you. And if you have, you know, Alexa or somebody that just will play music for you, notice what happens when a certain piece of music comes on and your body goes, oh, that happened to me just last week in a really sacred moment that connected me to something that was happening out there in real life. And I didn't even know it was happening until after it happened. Then I went, oh, wow, look what happened there. Mm-hmm. And so I invite you to, allow yourself to be a little bit vulnerable. And you're probably going like, hey, sister, you're preaching to the choir. We know vulnerability here. And yet, I'm going to tell you that we're more alike than we are different. And we all want to feel joy. And we all want to feel companionship in this life, connectivity. Yeah. And the one that usually gets shortchanged is the guy that lives in here, the gal that lives in here. We are so quick to share it and not always quite as consistent about loving ourselves first, being patient with ourselves, forgiving, all of those things. We all know them. They're just grown-up human emotions. Yeah. And music is one of the ways, probably the very number one way, music and movement, that my body gets spoken to. You got a whole brand new playlist this morning that evolved after I slept last night. And I said, no, that's not what spirit says. Spirit says this. My spirit says this. And so I thank you for coming along, for being courageous movers and shakers.